Is it bad to leave my iPhone plugged in?
It means the automatic updates run when it isn't inconvenient to you. You get to save time, but at the expense of the battery.
Charging a phone ensures that it has enough power.
Batteries are fickle creatures. Letting it run down to empty a lot causes it to lose its memory of being full, while batteries lose charge incrementally with every recharge.
Too much or too little, and they all cost you your battery.
Often running it to empty means it only recharged back to maybe half its former charge. Recharging it all the time by leaving it plugged in means the battery lasts a few months less than it would otherwise.
If the battery at half its charge, you may end up keeping it plugged in out of the hope it will last the drive home.
You also don't want to leave the iPhone plugged in all the time to the USB and the network. Your phone is at greater risk of infection when connected to PCs and other devices.
Leaving it connected means it syncs with my other devices better.
Simply connect it every night for a few hours and it'll charge and update just fine.
What else should I do to extend its life?
Don't drop it in the toilet. Don't sit on it and break it.
I meant battery life.
Don't use wireless charging, because that could actually overheat the battery.
And heat shortens battery life.
In the case of wireless charging, it is like microwaving the cell phone. It can, in rare cases, melt down.
I thought the Apple has overcharge protection.
It does, but not overheating protection.
How long does it take for recharging to hurt battery charge levels?
A couple hundred to a couple thousand charges.
I'm going to upgrade to the next iPhone model before the battery goes bad, if it takes a year or three to hold less power.
Then you're changing out the phone to replace the battery.